Sunday to everyone. Praise God, it is a glorious day. No matter if it rains or shines, it's a glorious day. The light is shining inside of us, and so we praise God, and we will praise God as the choir comes in, gets in their place.
morning, Temple Church. Good morning, those of you online. Sister Sandy will not be chatting with you this morning, so I'll try my best to be with you. Welcome. This is the day that the Lord has made. And be glad in it. Yes, Lord. Please consult your bulletins for the announcements, but I do have a special announcement on behalf of our Central Asia missionary sisters, Sandy and Dion. There will be a presentation on their trip on May 5, immediately after worship. So please join us. That should be a wonderful, wonderful experience. Okay, let us pray. Thank you, loving God, for bringing us to this time of worship. Refresh us and heal us again. Remind us of the many ways in which you have blessed our lives with your abundant love and your presence. Guide our hearts and our spirits that we may hear your words and our souls may be stirred into active service to your people. In the name of the Good Shepherd, who leads us to life, we pray. Amen. Let us rise for the opening hymn. Hymn number 381. Let us stand for the call to worship. Yes. Come, walk with the Lord this day. We seek places of peace and rest from the stresses of our lives. The shepherd will lead you to places where your soul may be restored. We come sometimes fearful of the hostilities of the world. In the midst of all the turmoil, the shepherd will provide your needs abundantly. Surely these wonders will heal and restore our spirits. Amen. Please remain standing for the opening hymn.
In my flesh.
let us pass the peace of Christ that transcends all understanding.
Peace, peace. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
God is so good. Amen. We are mostly home folks today, but I do see a couple of new faces. If you'd like to introduce yourselves to us or just wave at us, whatever you feel comfortable doing. If this is your first time, let us know that you're here. Very first time at Temple. Okay. Well, looks like we're all home, folks. Amen. Amen. So we are here together to worship and praise God. There are announcements in your bulletin, Sister Tia. Let us know that on May 5th that there will be the report from our missionary sisters who went to Central Asia. And so please be present to attend that. On next Sunday, tomorrow I will be leaving for North Carolina. I will be one of the delegates for our General Conference of the United Methodist Church. There will be 826 delegates, I believe, from all over the globe. Each annual conference elects a team of delegates, three clergy and three lay, and I was elected to be able to go and represent our annual conference. So, amen, amen, amen. We've got a lot of work to do before us. I'll be there in South Carolina almost 2 weeks. That is the conference length. And our United Methodist Church is changing. The budget has been cut by about 40% by disaffiliations and folks leaving the denomination. And so over the last 6 or 7 years, probably longer than that, the church has been undergoing schism. And the main presenting issue, although there's many underneath, has been over full inclusion of LGBTQIA+ siblings. The 30 some odd percent who have left the denomination are those who believe that they are LGBTQIA+ siblings. They think they should not be included in the life of the church. So those of us who remain are welcoming, inclusive, yes, and that's the way we believe that God's church ought to be. Amen. Amen. That's the way the table of the Lord is. And so those of us who are left, this is an exciting time to reimagine what our church will look like in light of a completely open table. So, amen. Amen. Of course, that means there will be some fighting and arguing over money and dollars, because that's a part of it all too, right? But God is going to do a new thing. God is doing a new thing in our church. And so I'll go to represent you all in North Carolina. Sister Sandy will preach next week. She'll be delivering the message. Amen, Sister Sandy. Amen. Sister Sandy is also our conference director of lay servant ministries. In case you didn't know that, she's training all of the lay speakers. And so she'll be preaching next week. And the following week, our Communion Sunday, you will have none other than the very own, our Reverend Ron Swisher will be here. Ron Swisher, if you don't know him, he is a legend in this annual conference. He served associate pastor at Glide for a season. He was a district superintendent, served at Taylor Memorial Church, Easter Hill Church. He's awesome. When I tell you he's awesome, I'm so happy that you'll be able to get a word from Reverend Ron. So don't miss the Sundays that I'm not here, because I'll be watching on YouTube to see. No, because I know it's going to be amazing worship. Amazing worship. So with that, just look at your neighbor and just smile and say good morning. Good morning. Children's time with Pastor Staci. Come on up. Where are all my kids? Yay! Clap for them. Come on. How are you guys this morning? You're good? Good. You guys look great. You look great. A shepherd? Not really, huh? Kinda? What does a shepherd do? We kinda don't know anymore, right? Because we don't have shepherds. Do you see a shepherd every day? No, it's an old language thing, but if you lived on a farm, how many of you guys been to a farm before? You're going to a farm at school? But we don't live on a farm. We live in the city, right? But if you go to a farm, we'll see there's lots of animals, right? And they are all led by their caretaker, right? So when you have sheep, you know, have you seen a sheep before? Okay. So when you have sheep and they're led by somebody, the person who leads the sheep is called a shepherd. Do you have pets at home? No pets? I love it. Kids after my own heart. But if you had, you have one? Sadly, we don't. But if you had a pet, what do you think you'd have to do? Like, let's have an imaginary pet. What kind of pet do we want? Okay, we know we all want a dog. So what would we name our dog? Come on, Seth, you give us a name. Rufus, okay. We've got a dog named Rufus, amen. Okay, so what do we need to do for Rufus? Feed him. And we'll train him. Up his poop, train him, feed him, walk him, play with him. So if you guys are walking Rufus, what do you have to do when you're walking him? Like if a car comes, what do? Look out for Rufus, right? So you guys would be like Rufus's shepherd. You would be like the one that takes care of Rufus, right? So that's really what a shepherd does. A shepherd feeds, takes care of, watches over, protects the sheep. Now, Jesus is called our shepherd. Do you know why? He protects us. He feeds us. He takes care of us. So when we call Jesus our shepherd, we're kind of like Rufus. We need somebody to take care of us, right? Do you need somebody to take care of you? Sometimes, right? And that's what Jesus does. He looks out for us. He feeds us. He protects us. He takes care of us. So there's a psalm in the Bible, and it's called the 23rd Psalm. And I want to teach you guys the very first line of it. You might already know it. It says, "The Lord is my shepherd." Can you say that? I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. And that means Jesus takes care of you every day, all the time, in every way. Amen? Amen. Remember Rufus. Remember Rufus. And remember that God takes care of you. Let's pray together. Gracious God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for these beautiful children. Remind them every single day of their lives that you take care of them. And they can always be protected and surrounded by you. We thank you, Lord, for our good shepherd. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 You guys did good. High five. High five, fist bump, hug, hug.
Okay.
High five, okay, 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 all right. All right, thanks be to God. Amen, and you have children's time. Oh, Lucelli's taking the kids today. Thanks be to God. Amen. Oh, okay. Thank you, Nan. We praise God for our children. And I really do pray that they would understand that God takes care of them. That these children's sermons, you know, are seeds being planted. That one day when they need it, they'll think about it and say, you know, God takes care of me. And that's the truth for all of us, amen?
Amen?
That God takes care of us. So this morning as we go to God in prayer, we remember that God is our good shepherd and he takes care of us. If you have a prayer request, you're invited to fill out the little yellow card in your pew and bring it up and set it on the altar, and we'll include those in our prayer time. If you'd like to come and kneel, the altar is open. If you'd like to come and light a candle, the altar is open. Come to the altar. Lay your burdens down. Shepherd us, O God. Lead us, O God. Lord, we come to you this day with our hearts full of gratitude, full of concerns, full of everything, O God. And so, God, we come first to lift up the prayers and praise of your people. Lord, we come today giving thanks and praise for Junie. We thank you, God, for the healing work that you've done for Junie. Junie, for those who don't know, was in an accident, and she's been in a coma. 19-year-old UC Davis student. Today she's talking, laughing, moving. We glorify God, and we pray for her continued healing. Lord, we pray for Johnny Heyer, a soon-to-be graduate. May you bless his future as he walks with you. We praise you for a successful master's completed program. We pray, O God, for a friend, John Pates. We ask for healing for Reginald Williams. A prayer for anyone seeking a church like Temple will find us and come home. Praise for our inclusive family of God, where all are welcome. Praise God. Prayers for Uchenna Capco, that she may continue to heal. Thank God for elevating our family. Thank God for kept promises. Praising God for his faithfulness and grace in my life. He has proven himself worthy again. Praise the Lord with me. Prayers for Sasha as she goes to camp tomorrow. Praying for God's guidance as she mingles with her new peers. May Sasha know that the Lord is her shepherd and she is protected and cared for. Asking for prayers for Carl, who is recovering and healing from dental surgery. Asking for prayers for Sister Joy as she travels to see her mini Joy, her grandbaby, Dylan. Prayers for myself, for Pastor Staci and family as we travel to the conference in North Carolina. Prayers for the health and safety of close friends, Jordan and Murphy Alvarado, during one of the most challenging moments of their lives. Lord, surround Jordan and Murphy. Added prayers for Reggie Williams. We lift in prayer Sarah Lydia, who lost her father on Friday. He was sick and it was time. They are happy that he is with the Lord. Healing for Carl. We ask for healing for Ray and for Juliana. I also lift up a special prayer for Gloria Jiggets this day and for her daughters, Teresa and Ayan. Shepherd us, O God. We need you as our good shepherd. Lord, you care for us. You make a way for us. You feed us. Lord, we're so grateful to be able to call you our good shepherd. And so, God, as we come and we lift up all of the prayers and praise and petitions on these little yellow cards, God, we just say thank you. We thank you, oh Lord, for Junie's recovery, for the process of recovery, Lord. We praise you. We praise you, Lord, that you are doing what you do best, and that is to be her God. We praise you that out of a coma, she is arising. And we ask, God, that you would continue, Lord, to wake her up. and restore her to health. Lord, for all of the prayers that we've lifted up today on these cards, Lord, we know that you hear them. We know that you are ever more ready to respond than we are even willing to pray. And so, God, we just thank you. We thank you for hearing the cries of our hearts. And we thank you, God, for all of those times when we have acted like we didn't need a shepherd. All of those times when we acted like we had it on our own. Lord, forgive us for our arrogance. Forgive us for thinking that we could handle this load, this burden of life on our own. Lord, we come today as your sheep. We come admitting that it gets heavy and that we need our good shepherd to lead us and guide us into the right way. And so, God, we present ourselves again today, saying thank you for all of the ways that you have led us, for your miracles, for your provision. We thank you, oh God. And God, it is our humble prayer that you would continue to lead us and guide us so that we don't fall astray. God, we lift up our world. We lift up our world to you, Lord. Shepherd, lead us. We need you, Lord, to lead us in our world, lest we are going into catastrophe, Lord. Pull us back from the edge, Lord. Pull us back and lead us into the paths of peace and love and righteousness. Lord, we have a vision that you gave us, and that is of a glorious banquet table where everybody is welcome and everyone sits together and we feast together, all your good children, Lord, around your table in peace and love. Oh God, where everyone has enough, where there is no more war, where there is no more pain, where there is nothing but peace, Lord, help us, God, to make your kingdom come, that vision may come to fruition on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you, Lord, for our good shepherd, Jesus Christ. And we join our hearts and voices in praying the prayer he taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen.
Crain.
And I'm still Lucy Crain.
Our readings today will be from John chapter 11 verses, chapter 10 verses 11 to 18, and we'll be reading from the Common English Version Bible. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. When the hired hand sees the sheep, the wolf coming, he leaves the sheep and runs away. That's because he isn't the shepherd. The sheep aren't really his. So the wolf attacks the sheep and scatters them. He's only a hired hand, and the sheep don't matter to him.
I am the good shepherd. I know my own sheep, and they know me, just as the Father knows me. And I know the Father. I give up my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that don't belong to this sheep pen. I must lead them also. They will listen to my voice, and there will be one flock with one shepherd. That is why the Father loves me. I give up my life so I can take it again. No one takes it from me, but I give it up because I want to. I have the right to give it up, and I have the right to take it up again. I receive this commandment from my Father, the word of the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
The throne.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Hallelujah. Forever you shall be. I just got to take a moment and worship. Just give me a moment. If you're feeling it, just join with me. Just if you're feeling the power and presence of the Lord in this place, just take a moment and worship God. If you don't know how, just thank God for everything that God has been for you, that God has done for you. Forever you shall be the Lamb upon the throne. God, I worship you this morning. Lord, we worship you. We thank you, oh God, that you have been our good shepherd, our provider. We worship you and you alone, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, O Lord, that we woke up this morning. Thank you, God, that our beds didn't become our deathbeds last night. Thank you, God, for allowing us to see a brand new day. Lord, we worship you. We worship you, O God. Forever you shall be. The Lamb upon the throne, Lord, we thank you. We glorify you. We magnify your name, Jesus. That means we make your name bigger. We shout your name, Jesus. Lord, I don't want to scare anybody this morning, but I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful, Lord, that when I think about your goodness, my soul cries out, hallelujah. I thank you, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that you would speak to my heart and give me words that will bring new life. We feel the power and presence of your Holy Spirit. Continue to speak, Lord. May the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be pleasing and acceptable in thy sight. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. God bless you, Uzoma. God bless you. God bless you for letting the Lord use you. Forever he shall be. I thank you, Lord. It's getting on 280 the other day, and it was a traffic jam. I'm coming on 280 from Serramonte, heading north. You know where that is, by the Target. I'm heading north over there, and it's a big traffic jam, and I'm saying, why should it be a traffic jam this time of day? It wasn't the morning rush hour. It wasn't commute. And what I saw is that there's metering lights. There's metering lights on that on-ramp. They're not on all times of day. Just in the mornings when there's commute traffic, I've usually seen them on. And so in the afternoon, when I'm cruising through there, I see these people stopping at the metering lights. So the traffic is all the way backed up off the on-ramp because everybody is stopping for the metering lights. That would be okay if the metering lights were on. But the metering lights weren't on. Wasn't the right time of day for metering lights. But somebody at some point decided that they were going to stop for the metering lights, even when the metering lights weren't on. And you know what that did? That started everybody to stop behind them. And it only takes 5% of the people to impact the whole crowd. So that one little person that decided that they would stop at the metering light when there was no light impacted the rest of us with stacked up traffic. You know what that's called? The sheep mentality. The sheep mentality. The sheep mentality is, you know, how your parents used to say, if everybody else went and jumped off a cliff, would you do too? It's the sheep mentality when you don't really think for yourself, so you just kind of follow the crowd. The sheep mentality. When Jesus is giving his sermon and talking to his disciples and saying, I am the good shepherd. You are my sheep. Some of them would have been offended by that. Now, we look at it as the shepherd who takes care of, and certainly they did too, but they would have been offended because, you see, sheep aren't very smart. That's why it's called the sheep mentality. Sheep don't have a good sense of direction. Did you know that? That sheep don't have an innate sense of direction. They just kind of wander all over the place. Did you know that if a sheep falls down and falls on its back, that it cannot right itself? That it needs somebody to come and turn it back around? That's called being cast down. When a sheep gets cast down, it falls and it's on its back. It cannot get up. Did you know that a sheep will stand there and graze on grass until there's just roots and there's no nutrition, but they won't leave anywhere. They'll just stay there gnawing on roots until they starve. Now, did you know that a sheep will go to dirty water and drink dirty water when fresh water is right there? They will drink the dirty water unless a shepherd leads them. Unless a shepherd leads them, sheep are pretty much defenseless. Sheep only have two ways to defend themselves. One is to run, and they're not very fast. The other is to kick, and they don't kick very hard. So when Jesus was saying, "You are my sheep," you can bet there was one or two folks in the crowd who thought, wait a minute, I'm offended. I'm smart. I know what I'm doing. How dare he call me a sheep? But if you remember from the Old Testament in the book of Ezekiel, God had said, I will be, O Israel, your shepherd. I will take care of you. I will comfort you. I will lead you. I will guide you, because sheep need to be guided. And Jesus says, you are my sheep. I am the good shepherd. Well, as they stood there listening to him, I'm sure they're racing. Their minds were racing with thoughts. Am I really a sheep? I mean, well, I just told you all these things about sheep not being very smart, not a good sense of direction, will chew in places where there is no food, will drink dirty water. Who would want to be considered a sheep? When they fall, they can't get themselves right again. They need the shepherd. Who would want to be considered a sheep? But if we step back a moment and look at our own lives, sometimes we graze in places where there is no food. Amen, somebody. Sometimes we drink dirty water. Amen. Sometimes we fall on our backs and can't get up. Sometimes we go in the wrong direction. Sometimes when things happen to us, all we can do is run and maybe kick a little. I think we are more like sheep than we want to admit. But Jesus knows. Jesus knows that we are sheep. Jesus knows that we do have a sheep mentality. Jesus knows, and he says, I am your good shepherd. I am your good shepherd. Emphasis on the word good. Because there's lots of shepherds out there, but I am good, the good shepherd. Because there's lots of phonies and counterfeits out there. But Jesus says, I am the good shepherd. And then he goes on to say, my sheep know my voice, and they're under my authority. I remember Juanita Halliday, God may her soul rest in peace. She was a lay leader in my church in Oakland. And when stuff would go wrong, or she'd just be sitting back, she lived to be 105 years old, full of wisdom, full of energy, right down to the end. She'd look back and she'd say, my. Any of you ever heard that expression? My. When you just look at things and look at stuff and you don't really have the words to say, my. As I was reading this scripture about Jesus being the good shepherd, I heard Juanita's voice say to me, my. And I looked in scripture and saw Jesus was saying the same thing. My. My sheep, my voice, my authority, my. My. My sheep. It's a possessive pronoun. They belong to me. Just like you say, my church, my kids, my car, my house, that's mine. And what Jesus is saying is, you are mine. You are mine. I take full responsibility for your care. In Idaho this week, and every year in April, there is a sheep migration. And Sister Elaine, can you put up the picture for me? A couple of pictures I shared. On Friday, Frank Schertz, who owns thousands, hundreds of thousands of sheep, that was on Friday, that he's leading his sheep, thousands of them, from the sheep low country up to the mountains of Idaho, so that they could graze to higher pasture. Frank says, those are my sheep, and I take care of them. You see Frank in the front, how he's leading them? That's how a shepherd walks. In his hoodie and his jeans on, Frank is leading his sheep. And Frank said this. Frank says, when you get a pretty band of sheep, you think, darn, you gotta love that. You love working with them. You love making them good. It's something you're proud of. But your sheep have to be taken care of. Someone has to be with them 24 hours a day so that they are taken care of. What Jesus is saying, surely if Frank can be with his sheep 24 hours a day, then our good shepherd is with us 24/7, 365, taking care of us. We are his sheep. And just like Frank is making sure nobody comes near his sheep, Jesus is making sure that nobody comes towards you. Jesus calls you my sheep because you belong to him and he's taking care of you. Like the kid said, what do sheep shepherds do? They feed, they take care of, and they even pick up poop. Amen? Amen. Amen. Our good shepherd takes care of us. My sheep. Jesus says they hear my voice. In a world where so many things clamor to get our attention, this is the tricky one. Because if we can get over our ego and say that I am a sheep, that I am a sheep of Jesus Christ, if we can get to that point where we're vulnerable enough to say, I'm a sheep, then we have to learn how to listen to the shepherd's voice. And in a world where so many different things clamor for our attention, how do we hear the shepherd's voice? Did you know that Americans lost $10 billion last year on scams? On scammers. The average person lost about $8,000 per encounter. $10 billion being scammed because they were listening to scammers. You got to be careful of fake shepherds out there. You have to be careful of people pretending to be somebody they're not. Yesterday I got a text from Fidelity Investments telling me that my phone number had been changed and I needed to go on and confirm it. That'd be great, but I don't have any account with Fidelity Investments. Do you see that the scammers are out there? And Jesus knew that the scammers were out there trying to prey on his sheep. That's why he said, you got to know my voice. You have to know my voice because there will be other voices out there. There will be scammers out there. But if you know my voice, Pastor Staci, how do we know the voice? If you read your Bible and if you sit in silence, you will know the voice of God. If you read the scriptures and know of the promises of God and be familiar with how God communicates, you will know the voice of God. If you sit in silence and stop talking for a moment, then maybe God will be able to talk to you and you will hear the voice of God, because there's scammers out there who will say that their voice is God's voice. We need to be discriminating. I invite you to have a hermeneutic of suspicion. A hermeneutic means an interpretation. It's a theological term. Have a hermeneutic of suspicion. That means you give things the side eye. Before you just take it as the gospel truth, give it a little once over. Be a little suspicious of it. There was a gentleman who told me years ago, he came up to me at a church conference, and be careful at the church conferences too, y'all. He came and told me, he said, the Lord told me you were going to be my wife. And I said, the Lord didn't tell me. The Lord didn't tell me, and guess what? It ain't happening. But imagine, if you didn't know the voice of God for yourself, people can sell you a bill of goods. But Jesus says, I am the good shepherd. And if you learn my voice, if you pray, and if you stay with me and learn my voice and learn my ways through scripture, you will know that I will lay down my life for you, because you are mine. Not long ago, we were in a restaurant, and it had all the great Yelp reviews. And the food was pretty good, but the service, we couldn't get anybody to bring us some cream for the coffee. It was about 5 minutes, and we looked at them, and they were all huddled around the coffee maker, the coffee espresso machine, just yapping it up, talking about their lives and whatever. And we kept doing this. Hello? And they were just looking, weren't even paying attention to us. And finally, John, you know, we just said, forget it. And we asked for the check. The food was all right, but the service was terrible. The next day we went to breakfast, and the service was amazing. Attentive. Would you like this? This is something I'd like to suggest to you. Here, try a little bit of this. Bring a sample and everything. And we said, oh my gosh, is this your restaurant? And he said, yeah, I'm the owner. The first restaurant, they had the attitude, I don't own this thing. Not my circus, not my monkeys. I don't care if you're not happy. Whatever. Pay your check and leave. The second restaurant said, this is mine. And I want to make sure that anybody who comes into my place is served with the utmost love and respect. Do you see the difference between the hired hand and the shepherd? That's how you can tell the real deal, is that the hired hand will leave you high and dry, but the good shepherd will come and care for you. My sheep. My voice, my authority. Jesus says that I lay down my life and I can pick it up again. What Jesus is saying is that I will do anything to make sure you stay safe. The shepherds had a pen. The pen was like a U shape, open U. Shepherds who owned the sheep would sleep right in the open part of the U, so that if any wolves tried to get in, the good shepherd is right there, and they'd have to come through him first. The good shepherd is laying down his life so that no wolves can attack the sheep. The hired hand is sleeping underneath the tree, and you're on your own. But Jesus is telling them, I will lay my life down for you. And didn't he prove it on Calvary? Frank's sheep are guided by Peruvian shepherd dogs. There's only two of them for about 1,000 sheep. But these dogs run all throughout the herd, making sure that nobody messes with the sheep. It's just two, but they're so ferocious that the Idaho government sends out warnings to people. If you see the herd and you're on your bicycle, get off. If you have a dog, pick it up, leash it. Because if those two Peruvian shepherd dogs see you on a bike or your little pet, they're gonna assume that you're a threat and they're gonna attack, because they're an extension of the shepherd and they're there to keep their sheep safe. We have a presence that moves among us, who is protecting us, who is keeping us safe. We have a presence, and I'm not saying the Holy Spirit is a Peruvian shepherd dog, but maybe the shepherd dog is like the Holy Spirit, amen, that is moving all around us. And if anybody gets too close, if anybody gets too close to the sheep, if anybody starts to attack, we've got the presence of the shepherd ready to attack, to keep you safe. There is a joy that comes in knowing the good shepherd. That's why David wrote these words: the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures, because if not, I'd eat dirt all day. He leads me beside still waters, because if he didn't, I'd be drinking dirty water all day. He restores my soul, because if he didn't, I'd be flipped upside down every single day. He leads me into right paths, because I don't have a good sense of direction, and I'd be following behind something ridiculous. For his name's sake, and even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, because that presence is with me. The rod and the staff, they comfort me. He prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. I fall down sometimes and hurt my head, so he anoints my head with oil. My cup. I don't feed myself. God feeds me. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord, in that shepherd's pen, where my shepherd lays down in front of me my whole life long. We're his sheep. My. My sheep, my voice, my authority. We got to know the shepherd, y'all. He's a good shepherd. Take some time to be still and listen to his voice. Take some time to get in the word and to study the way he speaks to you. Listen to his voice. when the King Samuel was little and he was hearing God call him for the first time, he was confused. He thought that it was Eli, his teacher, calling him, but it was really God. And when he finally understood the voice of God, he said, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." That is my prayer for all of us as we follow the Good Shepherd. Speak, Lord, for your servants are listening. Thanks be to God. Amen.
In the words of Miss Ellen, this church on fire, this church on fire. And I thank you, Pastor Staci. My brothers and sisters, as the ushers come forward, I invite you to consider opening your hearts to pour out that which our Almighty God has so generously poured into you. Please know that your hard-earned money does not just keep these lights lighting or this heater heating. Your hard-earned money also helps fund ministry within these church walls and outside of these church walls. And it is all, always, in the name of Jesus. Let us rise and sing. When did you ever not provide, even when we didn't? When did you ever not love, even when we didn't? When did you ever not pray for us, even when we didn't? Let us provide now, Lord. Let us love now. And let us pray over these, our gifts, which we cheerfully give back to you now. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen. Before we do our closing hymn, Sister Tia asked if we could have prayer before I go to General Conference. Yes. For you all to pray, and I wholeheartedly accept that. There's a saying that says, don't sit at tables that Jesus would have flipped. And increasingly, as I move towards Charlotte, I'm feeling an urge to flip some tables. And I'm not saying that that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I just want to be in alignment with Jesus. Amen? And not go there and just kind of be there. But if I go, I want to be sent. If I go, I want to be doing the will of God in that place. And, you know, there's this old story about a man who is reciting speeches in Carnegie Hall, and this great orator is there, and he's asking for people, you know, to say their favorite poem or whatever, and he'll recite it. And he recites all of this stuff, and then this old gentleman gets up and says, "I'd like you to say the 23rd Psalm." And he gets up and he recites the 23rd Psalm, you know, and it's vibrato and really great. And then the folks around know that this older gentleman has recited that psalm too, and they encourage him, "Get up and recite it." So he gets up and he recites, "The Lord is my shepherd." And by the time he gets to the end of it, there isn't a dry eye in the place. Because of the emotion, the feeling in which that old guy recited that psalm, he just knew he knew Jesus. And the orator got up and said, "You see what the difference was? Was I know the psalm. He knows the shepherd. He knows the shepherd." And that's my prayer, for me to go not only to North Carolina, but wherever I go, knowing the shepherd. And that's my prayer for you too, that wherever you go, you know the shepherd, you know his voice, that you are his sheep, and that you're protected by his authority. So sheep do have some good qualities. They're extremely loyal, amen, and they follow in packs really well, meaning be careful who you're around, because your company influences your life. And so I'm going to invite all of you sheep to come up, because I believe I'm in really good sheep company here. I do, and I want to humbly ask for you to pray for me. This prayer shawl was made for me and sent, this is the first time I'm opening it, by Susan Kopp. Susan is on our Bible study on Thursday. She's come and been a part of the church. This is what she sent, the note. "Good morning, my special sister. We will be putting a box in the mail for you, hopefully today. It contains a prayer shawl. It is knitted. It is a stunning piece of work, and I instantly thought of you. The shawl spoke your name to me the instant I saw it. If possible, on the Sunday before you leave, wear this to church and have it and yourself blessed. I am confident that it will carry you through. Your sister in Christ, Susan." Susan, you're watching. I thank you, and we're gonna do it.
Temple, I invite you all, as you are able, to come on down so we can lay hands on Pastor Staci. Almighty God, Lord, you are our good shepherd, and you have sent your deputy good shepherd here, Pastor Staci, to watch over us. Lord, she is traveling to the General Conference. Lord, let her flip over some tables. Lord, yes, Lord. Lord, let her and her spirit and those who share the same spirit be able to express that you are all-inclusive.
Yes.
Period.
Yes.
Yes, Lord. Lord, as Pastor Staci travels, as she wakes up tomorrow morning, let every single movement be glorified, Lord.
Yes.
Let your name be glorified in when she wakes up in her packing at the airport, at the seating in the airplane, Lord. Let it all be nothing but harmony and peace with her and the pilots and the flight attendants and the fellow passengers, Lord. Let every single path be anointed with your love. so that this deputy good shepherd can continue and be safe and be nothing but harmony and love, Lord. And as she goes to General Conference, flip those tables, dear God. Change those hearts. Change those hearts so that they all know, yes, you are all-inclusive, period. Lord, after General Conference, Pastor Staci will be traveling with another Deputy Good Shepherd, her husband, Pastor John Current, Lord. Lord, they will be traveling to Washington, D.C. with family for his commencement. Oh, Lord, keep them all safe. Keep everyone around them all safe, Lord. Anoint their paths, dear God, so that they can come home safely to us. Lord, we know that you are our good shepherd. And even if our deputy shepherd won't be here for 2 weeks, we know that we will be your sheep. We will be your sheep, Lord, because we know your voice. Lord, we love you. We glorify your name in everything that Pastor Staci will encounter and everything that Temple United Methodist Church will be here in her absence, Lord. And we love you, dear God, and we say all these things in your name. Amen.
Are we cool, Pastor?
I feel sent.
Amen.
I'm sent.
Are we ready? All right, here we go. Hallelujah. Please rise as we sing Cry of My Heart. Hallelujah. To follow you, Jesus. It is the cry of my heart. One.
Follow.
love to stay here. But again, our work is not on the mountaintop, it's down in the valley. So we follow our good shepherd into all the paths that he would have us to go. And we know that where he leads us, there will be green pasture. There will be fresh water. And you will be protected from danger seen and unseen. That's our good shepherd. So I'm sending you out into God's great, big, beautiful world. Because in spite of everything going on, it's still a beautiful world because it still belongs to God. Amen?
Amen.
And know that the unconditional love of our awesome God goes with you. Know that Jesus, our good shepherd, will be with you every single step of the way. And the Holy Spirit, that powerful Holy Spirit, will hold us all in the palm of God's hands. Till we meet again, God bless you. And I love you. Turn to your neighbor and say, God loves you, and so do I. God loves you, and so do I. God loves you, and so do I. God loves you, and so do I.
You might live barefoot today.
We'll have our charge conference in Tippett Hall at, let's make it in 15 minutes. So 10 of. How about that? Okay, we'll see you there.
All right.